Do y'all get thirsty? Yeah. How many of you like to play? Good. You like to play? Yeah. When you get really, really thirsty, there's only one thing that really, really satisfies, right? When you guys get really thirsty, what's the best thing to drink? Oh, this magic elixir, Coke. Isn't that great?
Yeah.
Well, listen. No, really. Really, water is probably the best liquid. Let's do a little experiment. We'll come to that. Today, I was thinking to myself, what would be the best thing to quench your thirst? And I went into the fridge and I realized that we had a lot of stuff. So this was pretty good, and that's why it's in there. How about this? Raise your hand if you would drink. Raise your hand if you would drink that if you're thirsty. Yeah. How about this one? There's grape juice. Yeah. I don't even think it's real. That makes it even better, right?
Yeah. That is my acty one.
How about this? It's
that
more of a.
My one.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, good, good, Reagan. Look here. How about something with antioxidant infusions? What do you think? None of you are raising your hand for that one. That's it. This has been in my refrigerator for about 2 years. I'll tell you. That's why. None of us won. But you know what? We're getting closer to that thing that we're talking about. We're getting closer. What's that? It's green tea.
Yeah,
do y'all like tea? Yeah. How about that? And last, how about this one? This is real close. This is sparkling water. It's regular water. It has a splash of lime in it, but it just has carbonation. But the last one is, this is the one that you all chose, right? Look at this. Look at this ingredient label. What's in there? Just water. Nothing. So here's our choice. We had a choice of juice or soda or water.
Water.
Yeah, no matter what you're thinking about, that water's always best. So look at what's inside. This one has aspartame in it. No, this one has something called stevia in it. Is that stuff good for you?
Yeah.
Probably not. But this one that all of you raise your hands for, what does it have in it? Besides grapes. Sugar. Sugar, lots and lots of sugar. Not so good for you. No. But I'm going to tell you a secret, and this is an important secret. Don't tell Auntie Alicia, okay? The healthiest choice is always... Yes, just a minute. I'll get right to that book in there. This is the healthiest choice of all. Water. Because you know why? It's going to quench your thirst. Now, if any of these said, if this Gatorade said, hey, if you drink this, you'll never be thirsty again, would that be pretty cool?
No.
Yes, that would be very cool. If you drank one of this and you never had to be thirsty again. Well, none of these drinks have that. But you know that Jesus said that? And in the story I'm going to tell you today, let's go to the woman at the well. So there's a woman who's sitting at the well, and Jesus is walking along. He's very hot and he's tired. And Jesus comes up and he sits at this well, and he looks at the Samaritan woman and he says, please give me a drink. And she is shocked and surprised because she's, excuse me, let me get my notes right here. So she says, why do you ask me for a drink since you're a Jew and I'm a Samaritan? And do you know what he said to her? He said, if you knew who I was, if you knew who was asking you for a drink, you would be asking me to give you living water. Living water. And you know what? She says to him, you don't even have a bucket to get water out of that well with. How can you give me living water? You don't have anything to give it with. If you go to the scripture next, Arlen, Jesus says, whoever drinks from the water of this well... Whoever drinks of the water of this well, and he's really talking about himself, he says, you'll never be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water of that well, this regular water, you're going to be thirsty. But if you drink from Jesus, you'll never be thirsty again. Now in the next, let's think about that. Jesus says he's living water. Is he talking about thirsting for just regular water, or is he talking about thirsting for something more important? God, right? Look at this. If you're thirsting for God, right, we have a thirst for the living God. And that's what Jesus is talking about. You put Jesus in your heart and you'll never be thirsty again. Now, water's important, right? Think about Jesus as living water to bring you closer to God and you'll never be thirsty again. Can you do that? All right, close your eyes. Let's pray together. Dear Father, Thank you for sending Jesus, our living water. We pray that each person here today will drink of that living water so that we'll never be thirsty again. Amen. All right. So, kids, you're going to go with Auntie Alicia. And everybody else, we're going to take a short break and refill your coffee cups and be right back. And say hello to each other. Hug somebody you don't know. You like?
Praise unbroken, praise unending. Be yours forevermore. Praise untainted, praise unfading. Be yours forevermore.